Initiation, the way to transformation. Man is asleep. His sleep is psychological. He listens, yet still he is not listening. Master observes this. A person who is on the borderline of this metaphysical sleep indeed needs initiation. He needs to be within the energy field of an enlightened master or awakened one. It is not that the seeker can see that I am on the borderline. It is always the master sees that this particular disciple, particular seeker is on the borderline. So Sufis say, master appears when the disciple is ready. He can hear something, he can understand something, he can see something as well. Everything around him is like the mist, yet still he feels something. Such a person is on the borderline. He approaches an enlightened one, not really knowing the essence of enlightenment or awakening. He is ready to surrender. This is the only way to wake up from his metaphysical sleep, sleep of lives. Only this much this person can do. Surrendering brings the understanding that something other than sleep is now happening. Somehow he feels this, but he cannot exactly know what is this. Whenever an enlightened one passes through a village, a place, those who are on the borderline of this metaphysical sleep can recognize that there is something different about this person. What he does, he sends his energy field wherever he goes, an aura, energy field surround. It is said about Hazrat Baba Samasani Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu that he used to stay in a particular village, and looking in the northerly direction, he used to smell something. The seekers asked him, what is that he is doing? He said, I am getting the smell of a beautiful rose flower from that side. 2 generations after, in the same village, was born Hazrat Shah Bahauddin Naqshband, and the Naqshbandi Tariqat evolved out of him. Various aspects of Sufism, Naqshbandi Hakimi, Naqshbandi, various other sects of Naqshbandi Tariqat all owe its origin to Hazrat Shah Bahauddin Naqshband Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu. A different breeze, a different energy field surrounds this person. He behaves differently, speaks differently, lives differently, he walks differently. Something different has happened to him. He looks like one of us, but in reality he is much more than human intellect can comprehend. He is the pulse of the cosmos. So those who are on the borderline can feel this, but they are still asleep. Also, the borderline sleep is transient. They can fall back into sleep anytime. Before they can fall back to sleep or into deeper unconsciousness, it is essential for them to surrender to an awakened one. This process is known as initiation. But this is from the side of the one who is to be initiated. He is incapable of doing anything for himself. He knows that if he does not surrender now, it will be impossible later on. This moment cannot be lost. Such moments come only once in our lives. It is not in anybody's hands to be on the borderline again. It happens for so many reasons that are beyond human control. This is the beginning of the process of initiation. On the part of the initiated, this refers to total let go, a state of total surrender. It can never be partial. A partial surrender is never surrender. This is like deceiving yourself. In partial surrender, you hold something within, and that which is withheld may push you again into deep sleep, and then you have lost the opportunity for many lives once again. Remember, the non-surrendered part will prove fatal. Any moment it can go back to sleep. Surrender is always total. For surrender, total trust is essential precondition. The moment you surrender totally, change begins to happen. Then you cannot fall back into dreams. When you surrender, the entire projecting mind gets shattered. This projecting mind is born out of ego. Also, it remains connected to the ego. So it cannot exist without ego. Ego is the base of this projecting mind. When you surrender, you have surrendered the cause of your existence up to now. You have given up completely. Initiation means that the person who was sleepy till now is seeking the help of an awakened one. He surrenders to one who is awake. Though it seems simple, it is not so. When you go to an enlightened one to surrender yourself, what are you surrendering? What are you really surrendering? Is your sleep, your dreams, your neurosis? Nothing else needs to be surrendered, because you are nothing more than your sleep, your dreams, and your neurosis. In fact, you surrender your sleep, your dreams and neurosis and the whole nonsense of the past. From the side of the initiated, this is surrender. Surrender of the past. But from the side of the one who initiates you, it is a responsibility for the future. It is a responsibility for transcendence and for the birth of a new man. One who is asleep can never be responsible. Responsibility comes with awakening. The word responsibility is very beautiful. It means one who has the ability to respond to each and every circumstance and situation. This is the fundamental law of life. One who is asleep cannot be responsible even for himself. And the awakened one is responsible even for others. So when you come to an awakened one, he becomes responsible for you. That is why an awakened Krishna could tell Arjuna, leave everything and come to me. Surrender at my feet. Or as Jesus says, I am the truth, I am the door, I am the gate. Come and pass through me. I will certainly be a witness on the last day of your judgment. I will answer for you. Each master is a door through which you pass. This is analogy. Every day is the day of judgment. Not only every day, instead every moment is the moment of judgment. There is nothing like the last day. My grandmother Sufi, Naqshbandi master, never said things that we say. Somebody will bow down to her. She will simply say, be always happy. We are accustomed saying things like, God bless you. It seems that you are the custodian of God. You know everything about him. So on his behalf, you can say, God bless you. And when it is said, God bless you, it is not your responsibility. When you say, God bless you, you have shifted the responsibility on something which is hypothetical. When it is said, be always happy, the responsibility is yours. Every moment, circumstances and situations present themselves to test your awakening. We are never happy for everything that happens around us. We say, if it was so, as if you are imposing your will on that of the... The moment you accept everything in its totality, I mean totality, then change begins to happen. This is in your hand. The moment you accept, you have accepted your responsibility. Not that you are shifting responsibility on someone else. You accept it. Because there are always two choices, either to accept it or not to accept it. When you accept it, you are happy. When you do not accept it, you are sad. So when you have learned in your life to accept everything and be happy, then what happens? Change begins to happen. So then there will be no last day of judgment. Every moment is the day of judgment. You choose to be happy under all circumstances, situations. Not only every day, instead every moment, there is nothing like last day. These were the words of Jesus that he spoke to his disciples who could understand him. They were within the energy field of Jesus, and this had brought to them an understanding of the message of Jesus. Yet still they could not understand the energy field of Jesus. As long as Jesus was in the physical form, they knew him. The moment resurrection happened, the form changed. They could not recognize the energy field of Jesus. It was only Mary Magdalene who could recognize that this is the Master. Mary is the disciple. However, the present-day followers of Jesus cannot understand the message. They are only interested in business, not the transformation. Jesus was in fact saying, I will be responsible for you, and I will answer for you in front of the Father. I will be there as a witness surrendered to me. I will be your witness. This is the responsibility of the Master. When he initiates you, he undertakes to transform you so that a new being is born out of you. No one who is asleep himself can take the responsibility for you. He can be responsible for others only when he need not be responsible for himself. He is unburdened. He is no more. He is just the pulse of the unknown, an emptiness that simply echoes the whispers of the unknown. He is the manifestation of the unknown in finite form. So only such a person can really initiate you, not otherwise. No particular person can initiate anyone. And if this happens, it is like a blind trying to lead the blind. However, in reality, both perish. One who is asleep cannot initiate, but the ego cannot help. This attitude is dangerous. The whole initiation, the whole mystery of it, the whole beauty of it has now become so ugly because of those who were not entitled to initiate. Only one who is not plagued by ego, who has no dreams within, can initiate. Otherwise, initiation is a great sin.